Yo, remember yeah. back on the Bully when cats used to harmonize yeah. like.
Yo,
my men and my women, don't forget about the dean. This is not the most of king. Yo, it's about a thing. Yeah,
feel yo. Real good when your hands in the air and lick two shots in the atmosphere.
Since you were looking for your friend, the one you let hit it and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? Yeah. You act like you and him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gon' pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even fooling him. If you did it then, and you probably talking out your neck, saying you're a Christian. A Muslim, sleeping with the gin. Now that was the sin that did Jezebel in. Who you gonna tell when the repercussions spin? Showing off your ass cause you thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gin, baby girl. Respect is just the minimum. But you still defending them now. Lauren is only human. Don't think I haven't predicament. Let it sit inside your head like a million women in Philly pen. It's silly when girls sell their souls because it's sin. Look at where you be in. Hair weaves like Europeans. Fake nails done by Koreans. Come again. A win-win. Come again. To the men, more concerned with his rims and his Timbs and his women. Him and his men come in the club like hooligans. Don't care who they offend, popping yang.
Like you got yang.
Let's not pretend. The one to pack pissed out by the waist, man. Crissed out by the casement. Still the name of his basement. The pretty face man claiming that they did a bit, man. Need to take care of their three and four kids. Been the face in court case when the child support's late. Money taking home, breaking out. You wonder why women hate me. The sleepy silent man, the punk domestic violence man, the quick to shoot the semen. Stop acting like boys and be men. How you gon' win when you ain't right within? How you gon' win when you ain't right within? How you gon' win when you ain't right within? Come again.
All right, guys, what's happening, man? Man, it has been a long week, man. If y'all don't know, you know, well, of course, this is Thanksgiving, so, man, welcome back. I hope you guys had a wonderful, festive Thanksgiving. I came back from Louisiana, turning up with my family, and, man, I had a wonderful time. I shall say, I went down there for Bayou Classic, went down there for the game. Unfortunately, we did lose Southern, you know, but whatever, man. I know. But I was out there with my friend, you know, with my homegirl, Kia. And, man, I'm going to play a little clip for y'all real quick and just show y'all what y'all was just turning up with, you know?
To life and family, don't
worry. Yeah, wait.
Come on, take a shot. Come on.
Sit fast. You
let's go.
No, I'm not.
Mama, you gotta do
that.
No, I. This by cut.
That was easy. I had more shots.
And we
than
in that thing. Mama, take the shot.
Take the shot. Keep going.
Come on, chuck it.
I have one more in there. If you don't chuck this, we're going to make you another one.
No, you're not.
What are you doing?
Go make your auntie a shot.
I do a take. I didn't think take a shot.
Hi, honey.
I was crying.
So, look, that's me turning up with my family, man. I was trying to get my mom to take a shot right now.
I like your mom.
Oh, man, she's cool. Like, she
takes shots like me.
Yeah.
Oh, sipping. Just come on now.
I be trying to get her to chug the shots, like, seriously.
No.
But, man, yes, that was my week off, guys. And, again, I do thank y'all for tuning in to Cameo Live 2.0. Man, I do apologize, guys. I am your host, Darius Porter. Check us out, man. But it's okay, man. We doing stuff a little backwards today. Please excuse me. I'm just excited today. And guys, I do want to let y'all know about my beautiful guest co-host right here, Miss Anisha right here.
Woo!
The beautiful choreographer,
what's
man.
Up?
She is in the building. If y'all don't know about this girl, please follow her. Anisha, what is going on, baby?
What's up? Man. You know, we in here. We doing this.
I'm
just excited to be here. I was like, right? Yes.
Man, this girl is stunning. She's beautiful. And she can dance. So later on in the segment, man, she's going to teach us how to do a look. I ain't gonna let y'all know yet.
Don't tell him.
Y'all just y'all tell
him. Don't tell him.
Yes, you know we're gonna hit that. Y'all on y'all ass. But anyway, man, we're gonna get right into it. Oh, actually, I do have a little. If I'm not mistaken, I got a little clip. I don't know if you know about this. I put one of your little YouTube links up. Now you look, man, my girl has followers, okay? Bunk followers. Mommy.
You know, I'm just trying to be like you.
I'm trying to get on your level. You know what I'm saying? So I'm humble. I'm thankful that you're here to grace us with your beauty and your presence. You know? So we're gonna run this little clip real quick.
I swear to God I'm moving on. God, I'm moving on.
My girl over here mad at me, y'all. You know, I'm just about to be real with you. Anisha is heated at me. I accidentally played the wrong video, and she's trying to throw them blows.
We're doing damage control now. We're gonna get the right one up.
That one was cute, but like my latest work was to the new Missy joint.
Right, you know,
and it's so serious. It's Missy.
Don't worry, I got you.
You got me, Josh.
Damage control is on its way.
Thank you, Josh. That's why Josh is here. That's what put him.
Bam, bam, got him.
Wham, bam, bam.
But you know, I ain't even gonna expose the truth. But it is what it is, man. But we're gonna jump to these hot topics real quick, man. And,
We're
going to come back and play Miss Anisha's Gibbs, Miss Yellow It, Crunk, you know, because you're doing your thing, and I want to, you know, get you out there how you want to do it.
I appreciate you.
Okay. So let's see what we got on next. Man, we do have to talk about that San Bernardino shooting. I apologize right now. It's just a kind of depressing topic.
It's a little Debbie Downer topic.
It is. So we just going to run, we got a clip, so we're going to run through this real quick.
Check back in with our Peter Dowd, who's on the ground. Peter, can you tell us where your location is exactly?
Pat, I'm at San Bernardino Avenue near Riverview Drive, and just within the last few minutes, police have opened up traffic in this area. I don't know if you could see all these cars, but still a very heavy police presence here. At the front of this line, there's an officer who is actually checking the IDs of all these drivers. They're still not taking any chances. Police definitely on heightened alert still. I believe we have video earlier of some of these officers as they were checking, as drivers were coming in and out. A lot of those drivers were at a standstill. Some of those drivers actually went witnessed the shootout with the suspect and also the police officers earlier this evening. They described the chaos of seeing the suspect stop at the intersection, get out of the vehicle, and then start firing at the officers. In fact, I spoke with one gentleman just moments ago who describes exactly what he saw.
A driver and a passenger, kind of, you know, scorpion-looking guys, and looking back, and, you know, just, wow, like, I just literally saw their faces, and, you know, I did not see any weapons. They were shooting at the cops, but most likely they were, because I was nervous and scared, and, you know, what's going on, but I wanted to see a good eye of what's going on, and ducking down, of course.
You said you saw their faces. How did their eyes look? Were they scared?
They looked scared. They looked scared looking back.
And you just heard from that witness describing exactly the composure of those suspects, saying that they themselves seemed scared once the gunfire started. A lot of people here who worked nearby got out of their businesses, came.
Man, that is just horrible right there for somebody to come in our city and just shoot up 14 people. That's and insane. Wounded like 20 people.
Yeah.
21.
21?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's just terrible, man. So,
I just can't believe all these massacres. Like,
right.
Why are they, like, back-to-back
back
like this?
Back-to-back. Like, and it is nothing now for the wake-up and, hey, it's a massacre
just
shooting.
Just a massacre just, like, in my backyard.
It's nothing.
No big deal.
Did y'all see the number that somebody was saying? It's, like, 251 mass shootings in this year.
No, it was 300. 300 and mm-hmm. something, and there's 300 and something days.
In the year.
It's, like, almost so matching, like every other day.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It's
no,
horrible.
Pretty much every day.
The government's behind it.
But that's crazy, because that guy was in the States. You know, he
don't
was born,
come from me,
raised
government,
in
but
the States, in here. So
I mean, but that's what they do. They plant it. They, even people, friends and family, oh, like, I never thought he'd do this. And didn't the wife work at the place?
She was pregnant. Well, she had a six-month-old, and she was in it.
They
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, if you look at their social media, they're like this happy-go-lucky family. Here they are taking family
but for
trips.
Her to be pregnant, I mean, for her to just have a baby, you know what I'm saying? And then you want to just commit a massacre crime like this. Just
I don't know.
Horrible.
Something went down.
It makes you wonder
something,
what's behind it.
Exactly. Right. Like, that's just going to pop off, and that's it.
Right. But if you see something, guys, what they say something, because you just never know. I mean,
we see it.
Okay.
Report that shit. You know?
I ain't saying nothing. I'm not trying to get in trouble by the government.
Right. Because, you know,
guys,
they tapping
please,
in. Don't
come
everything.
Get me. They are.
They are.
They're probably watching us right now talking about she's crazy. We're going
to
get her.
Well, right. Shout out to San Bernardino.
Yes.
The people of the IE.
Shout out
Inland
to the
Empire.
Officers, too, who responded on first call. Like, seriously. Y'all
prayers
all
to
bad,
the families.
You know, so.
Prayers to
our
all
prayers go
family.
To your family and everybody who
they
was.
They were just having a little old party. They wasn't bothering
Christmas
nobody.
Party. Man, that's crazy.
And they said right
you never
when they
know.
Got lit,
you just never know.
They came through.
No.
That's
never
horrible.
Know. All right, man. We're going to go to our next hot topic. Man, if y'all did not watch Real Housewives of Atlanta, I mean, Portia and Cynthia must have been going through it. I mean, I don't know if she was on her period or I don't know if she was going through menopause
Cynthia
or not.
Cynthia talked to NeNe right before. That's
it
what
had
happened.
To be,
had
but my to. Girl was on 100. But
she ain't ever like that.
Right. Well, we didn't see the altercation, but I mean, from the looks of it, somebody got kicked. And, of course, it looks like Portia got her ass knocked out. But we do got a...
Portia was the first one to swing.
Yeah, but Cynthia, you know, 9-inch heel went upside her stomach and did some damage. So let's watch this clip, man. And I want to see what you guys think, and we want to hear from you guys. So call us in at 323-965-1600, man. We do want to hear from you guys. So let's run this clip.
All right, y'all. Now we have some real big Housewives of Atlanta news. Okay, reports are saying, y'all, that there was another fight during filming. Now, we want to go around the room and let's just see if anybody can guess who it was between.
Did the champ defend her title?
What? I thought we were going around the room. How is around the room everybody's eyes on me?
Ain't nothing but some housewives. You're the only one.
We don't got no peach. A plum, maybe, but no peach.
Well, anyway, we're hearing, y'all, that there was a fight between Cynthia and our lovely, beautiful, talented, sexy, gorgeous Miss Portia the other day on a yacht? Girl, y'all fighting on a yacht?
A boat.
Oh, it was a boat?
Yeah, but what are you talking about? What fight?
But nevertheless, it was sad though, y'all, but I hope this is not true because I love Portia. It was reported
that you were kicked in the stomach by Cynthia. How could she do such a thing? How could a grown woman kick another woman in the stomach?
Wouldn't that be awful?
It would be awful, Portia.
Oh, my God.
So, Portia, would you like to elaborate on this?
Well, I think you have to tune in.
Did anybody have to visit a place that rhymes with Shashbibble?
I cannot confirm nor deny.
What? Well, did... So,
Shashbibble.
No, so you're really not going to tell us nothing.
I mean, now y'all know I can't just tell y'all, you know.
But did you have to go to the
hospital? These crazy ass girls get into on this show.
Well, Portia, did you have to go to the hospital? Because they said you were rushed to the hospital, and I know that you weren't here on the other day.
I'm sitting right here.
Exactly, today.
I can't even twerk today to show you that I am not, have not been hospitalized like that.
You know, because if you lost a fight, you're not going to twerk.
You're not able to. You're,
emotionally, you can't even,
emotionally,
like.
Emotionally, you should be shamed to shake that ass.
Okay, let's treat this like a movie. Mm-hmm. Give us the trailer version. Just give us the little tease.
Okay, I'll give you the trailer
version. Screw that. I want that twerk.
So we're on a boat.
So it was a boat. It wasn't a yacht.
On Lake Lanier.
Oh, it was a boat.
So imagine. There were six ladies. They're out there looking glamorous. They're looking beautiful. There are drinks going and everybody's having a good time. And all of a sudden... Tune in to see the rest.
Weakest trailer ever. So with that twerk, though. Twerk it, work. Twerk it, work. Twerk it, work.
Twerk it, work.
Twerk it, work.
Twerk it, work.
Twerk it, work.
Well.
Twerk it, work.
Twerk it, work. Twerk it, work. There was not a kick in the stomach. Maybe we have to tune in.
Boom!
Like what you saw? Was you feeling the vibe?
Man, and that is Portia right there saying to herself. She wasn't hospitalized like that. So, bitch, you been to the hospital, you feel me? That girl kicked in your goddamn stomach, you hear me?
And girl, you- it came with reason, though.
Right. Huh?
I saw what happened.
Yeah,
I mean, I wasn't there, but like...
You on the boat.
No, where I wasn't on the boat.
Let me find out.
Stupid. No, but, okay, first of all, what it seems as if Portia jumped on Cynthia. Like... Portia was the one who initiated the physical...
Someone give her a speech or something. Well, had she to. Jumped on. Yeah.
Well, had to if Cynthia had to kick her in the stomach, I mean, to get her off of her.
Portia be doing the most. They she all did. Be doing the most. Yeah,
she was in her face.
Like,
what happened was, Portia called Cynthia a bitch. Cynthia didn't like how she said it. She was like, that didn't sound endearing. It sounded like you were calling me a bitch, and you said whatever right after it. And so she felt some type of way. Cynthia walked away, left the situation. Portia comes running back behind her, and it's like, yada, 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 I'm trying to apologize, what's wrong with you? And she's in her face.
No.
Yes, that's what happened.
Cynthia was already on 100.
Like, Cynthia was on like 80.
No,
Cynthia be so scary, though. Like, all of a sudden.
Right. Like, but Cynthia, she walked away.
Right, right.
You'd be like, you know what?
No, damn well, you ain't going to pop off. Like, you're not going to pop off.
She did put her finger in her face.
And he was like, girl, I know I don't be on the show like that no more. I know I ain't on the show like that. Right. You need to come through.
I think Portia popped off because Cynthia put her finger in her face. She was like, bloop, bloop, uh-uh.
But it should have never even gotten there. You know what I'm saying? Why did
this
Cynthia
is my opinion.
Have to take it there?
This know? Is my opinion. These are grown women who are always friends one day, fighting the next. Right. I'm like, really, y'all, make up your mind. Like, you grown ass. Like, we passed 35 years old. Why are y'all still fighting like petty little girls?
Ratings.
It's for a check. It's for these ratings.
It's pathetic.
It's giving people, like our people especially, a bad name because y'all are being a hot mess.
It is.
Get out of here. Like,
but you know, I can't even lie because, you know, if I was collecting them checks, you know what I'm saying? I'd be bing, bing, bam, bam.
They both still mad.
Still mad. And she's talking about twerking. Like, sit down.
Right.
We didn't even see nothing go off. You twerked under the table.
No, Portia, they calling you fake out there.
Right.
I didn't say all that.
Let's talk about the radio guy's shirt.
No.
Man. They say you up there looking like a flamingo, my boy.
A flamingo.
You feel me? Looking like a Hawaiian.
I do not condone the negative comments towards other radio stations.
It's not negative. It's just like, let's talk about it.
You know. Well, you know, guys. We're going to cut to a little music break for y'all real quick. Y'all turn up, man, and tune right back in, man. Shout out to our sponsors, Pitbull Energy Drink, man. Let me tell y'all something. Y'all need this in y'all life. For real. Forget a...
Pitbull Energy.
A red what? Man, it's a pit bull. We'll be right back.
Just listen to the music. This is how we put it all night.
I'm alone in my room. Sometimes I stare at the wall. Automatic weapons on the floor, but who can you call? My damn bitch, one who live by the code. Put this music to the side, get it in on the road. A lot of quiet time, pink bottles of rose. Exotic red bottoms, whole body glittered in gold. Following fundamentals, I'm following in the rental. I love a nasty girl who swallow what's on the menu. That money triple up when you get it out of state. Need a new safe cause I'm running out of space. Elroy Jetson, I'm somewhere out of space. In my two-seater, she the one that I would take lead.
According to the music, this is how we pull away all night. Breezing down the freeway, just me and my baby.
Took some sense and made a nickel love it. I'm urging all daughters to kiss their mothers with those lips that all that lipstick covers. You're never too grown up to miss and hug her. And girls counting on me to be there like missing rubbers. I'm on some Marvin Gaye shit, a bunch of distant lovers. This ain't the life that I'm used to. Reintroduce the people I've been introduced to. Did you forget me? Or are you too scared to tell me that you met me in fear that I won't remember? I wish you could still accept me for me. I miss Memphis, Tennessee, my cousins, my dad. The simplistic beauty that all of them southerners have. I'm halfway across the world with dozens of bags. Feeling like all four members are calling me bad. And one nigga, amazing shit. I got that Courtney love for you, that crazy shit. I don't drink every bottle I own, I be aging shit. And I got them wedding ring flows, that engaging shit. Which one of y'all got fleets on your keychains and seats for these heat games? I really think that you stare at yourself and you see things. La familia, I've been inducted and instructed to stunt on these niggas we don't really fuck with. Fuck is up. Having lunch and debating Ferrari prices. 23 and going through a midlife crisis. But trust me, I still deliver like a midwife. And no, I'm not saying I'm the nicest, I just live life like it. It take a certain type of man to teach to be far from hood but to understand the streets. I never threw away that paper with my Grammy speech because I haven't hit the pinnacles I plan to reach. Yeah, you gotta own it if you want it. Kisses all on the body, she tells me live in the moment. And baby, I never forget none of that. Girl, I told you I was coming back.
Would have came back for you. I just needed time to do what I had to do. Caught in the life, I can't let it go. Whether that's right, I won't ever know. Hope you forgive me, never meant wrong. Tried to be patient and waited too long. But I would've came back, but I would've came back.
All right, guys, and we are back, man. Anisha had to go to the restroom real quick, so she's trying to keep herself.
I made it back quick.
I did have to put her on blast real quick, but that's okay, man.
It's all right.
Anyway, man, she didn't want to talk about this Donald Trump situation anyway, man, but I'm about to get on it.
It's not that I didn't want to talk but about him. He's so wise.
He is wise. That's what I'm saying. We're going to rip on his corny ass. And on top of that, guys, if y'all didn't hear, man, he met up with 100 black preachers, supposedly. I'm guessing, supposedly. And
somebody from the past just put him on blast, though.
Sure did.
Oh, yeah, they did.
I forgot his name, though.
Me, too. But the clip, and we have...
Me, too.
one of the Republicans, one of the pastors is backing, well, he's a Republican, so he's backing Donald Trump on this foolishness, this buffoonery, okay? Mm. But we got a clip, man. Y'all watch this stupid ass shit.
I thought it was an amazing meeting. I thought that I met some fantastic people, some of whom I've known. I thought it was an absolutely amazing, you know, it lasted for 2.5 hours. We came up with lots of good ideas and lots of future ideas, but I thought it was an amazing meeting.
And how did you address some of the concerns that were raised?
Well, I think we'll be addressing them over the coming months and even over the coming years. I mean, these are deep-seated difficulties that certain communities have, and we're going to address them. And if I'm put in a position where I can do something about them, which in this case happens to be president, we will be working very, very closely with everybody, and we're going to be solving a lot of problems. Right now you have black youth. If you look at African-American youth, where it's 51 and 55 and 57% unemployed, you have African-American people of different ages where it's double and triple other numbers. So we're looking at a lot of different things, but this meeting was amazing, amazing people. We must have had close to 100 people in the room. And I just want to thank you. I want to thank both of you. And in particular, I'll tell you what, there's a whole group of people.
Really? Man, I don't even know where to start at getting on his corny ass.
Oh,
let me get on this fucking Pastor Richmond Raley, who endorsed the Republican candidate, Donald Trump, corny ass.
Traitor.
You know, man, who you think gonna vote for you, man? You disrespect everybody.
Get him.
From the women to the Africans to the whites to the Jews. You know what I'm saying, man? You do not care. Your tongue has no filter, man.
Nothing.
You wag. Hey, get him.
Yo, your toupee ass looking like mama. Like, you weedies looking like.
My nigga, you lying.
You wrinkly ass face looking right. Like, get out of here.
Scooby-Doo having it.
Scooby-Doo having
man, ain't nobody checking for you, nigga. Like,
not at
all,
man.
23 looking
right. You know what I'm saying? Nobody voting for you, Donald, my boy. I don't care how much money you have.
No, and if you are, you're dumb as fuck. Like,
right.
Come on.
Exactly. You're so whoever endorsed
you. He had a reality show. How do you have a reality show? Like, your main chick that's probably going to be supposedly vice president. Was on a reality show running
Amber
around.
Rosa, who looking like your pit bull.
Amber Rosa.
Like your pit bull right there, you know what I'm saying? However you pronounce her, man.
Omarosa.
Omarosa.
Who cares?
Exactly.
That's what it is.
Exactly. Nobody's checking for you at all either. So, anyway, man, next topic. We're going to go to our last topic, man.
You be telling lies.
What? Man. Erykah Badu, man. If y'all didn't hear, man, she dissed Iggy.
Erykah.
At the Soul Trains Awards.
She got a good, though.
And she got her good life. So, man, like she said, man.
Erykah's
and,
a boss.
You know. Iggy, man, I don't know what to say about you. You know what I'm saying? I like your shit, but, you know, you already know what it is, man. You commercial. And
I'm going to need you to stop spitting.
Think about it. Where is Iggy?
Oh.
Right.
Where is she?
She's in hiding. She's in hiding. Oh.
All I know is I ain't seen in a minute, so where'd the girl go? Sorry.
Okay. So, man, we're going to play this. I think, we got a clip, man. Yeah. Soul Train Awards, man. Y'all watch this.
Erykah Badu disses Iggy Azalea during her monologue at the Soul Train Awards on Sunday.
Hang on 1 second. I'm sorry, y'all. Yes. Who is this? Iggy Azalea. Yeah, hey. Oh, no. You can come, because what you're doing is definitely not rap.
I said, baby, I do this. I thought that you knew this. And no haters, and none is the truth is.
Iggy has yet to respond to the diss, but Erykah did reply to one Twitter user who defended Iggy, calling the Iggy fan a killjoy. Iggy has had a tough year in the media. She canceled her Great Escape tour in May and has had several beefs, including one with Q-Tip, Papa John's Pizza, and Steve Madden.
It's very difficult to be the new kid and to be the butt of the jokes and to be just directed with all, like, you know, the direction of all the negativity. And
in September, rapper T.I. made headlines when he admitted he no longer speaks to his former protege.
But the thing is, in her defense, she had a lot thrown at her at one time.
All right, let's go. Come on. Man. Did y'all see that, man? Man, Erykah went off on Iggy.
She did.
She did, man.
She came strong, too. She said, hello.
Right? Iggy, you don't belong there.
Ooh.
That's not.
You ain't a rapper.
You know that's not for you.
I do like Fancy though. Was cute. Yeah, I did a whole concert video. I mean, I just did it, but honestly, I did a concert video because I didn't like her video.
Right, I feel you. But you're a good dancer. You know what I'm saying? So you can outshine anyone. You know what I'm saying? She does a ducky. So, hey, man, we got her videos too. But we're going to play it for you real quick. We got him. All right, man. So, yeah, man, we want to hear from you guys too. I want to know how y'all feel about that whole Erykah Badu and Iggy situation, man. So give us a call, man. 323-965-1600. Hold on one time. Okay. I think my engineer has something to say. What you got to say, LaRon?
I was going to say that Iggy Azalea, she ain't no rapper. She a what the fuck.
A WTF, man. A what the fuck. Nobody checking. Nobody checking for her. Right.
I was about to say.
Where they from. Exactly. Before we go to commercial, guys, we're going to play our girl Anisha. Correct. Let me let her intro. Anisha, go ahead and intro, yo.
You know what? This is the new Missy joint. Missy just came back with, I feel it's a pretty ill song. It's her style. It's not what everybody's doing. She came through. So as soon as I heard it, I felt like I had to do something just as crazy as Missy would do. I was like, what would Missy do? OMG. So if you do, like, you know, should I tell him or should I say it after?
Tell him.
Just pay attention to the video. See if you know what's going on.
Pay attention to the video, guys.
Fast, make you think you're drinking. Yeah. Head to the floor, don't collect that dough. You better huddle up, cause the beat's so cold. Huh? Pop that, cock and reload. This another hit, I got an ace in the hole. Boys on my back, player, did you pick that? You got a small stack, player, you can keep that. Huh? I'm a Big Mac, make you wanna eat that. Like, yak to the yak. Yeah. Junk in the trunk, make it pumps in the bump. Girls wanna have fun, make you stick in that tongue. Sure. The dance that you're doing is dumb. How to do where you from?
Come me back in real quick. Man, guys, I mean, I have a yoke on my face right now because when I first got in this video, I thought this was a dope ass video, but I thought it was her and two other girls. So I wanted her to get her shine, look, you know what I'm saying? Real talk. And man, she just said that's all her. Them three girls were her, you know what I'm saying? So I feel kind of stupid right now. But man, girl, you did your thing, Anisha. Like, you
did
your man, Missy. Get this girl on your team, man. You know what I'm saying? This is your choreographer. Like, this is your dancer. You know what I'm saying? We're going to make it happen for real, man. You did your dug.
I'm telling you, like, that's something like Missy would do. Like, I heard the song. I was like, I know Missy's song is going to drop today, the 12th when it actually dropped. Right. And I was like, I made up choreography that same day. I heard it. I was feeling it. It was just fly. So I just banged it out. Trying to call people. I was trying to call people, and you know everybody's schedule's crazy.
Right.
So it was like, ooh, I can do it this day. Ooh, I can do it that day. And I was like, no, I need this to drop now. ASAP. Right. Like Missy song drop, then my video needs to drop.
Exactly.
Like it needs to be that serious. And my friend was joking around. She was like, you got enough energy. You can like command, like have them make a bunch of you.
Right.
And I was like. You know the cartoon, the thing comes up. I was like, light bulb.
Right.
My home, like the dude, he's never done it before, and he was like, let's go.
I need his.
And
number.
We legit, like, his name is Khalik. He's bomb.
Shout out Khalik.
He's everything. He did that.
And how long did it take? Like, what was the preparation behind it? Like, man, it took months for her to create that. But like, the girl's a wonder right there, man.
No, like it was literally a day. Made up the choreo. My friend said that. My boy came through. We shot it, and we had 3 hours to shoot. It took us an hour to set up, so we had 2 hours to shoot. I had to change my outfit 9 times.
Damn.
I had to do each character, and then he changed the angle. I had to do each character again.
Damn.
Then he did close-ups. Had to do each character again, and then we took the picture, each character. So about 9 times.
Determined, man. My
girl
had
to do
driven.
It. 2 hours, banged
like
it
Olivia
out.
Like Olivia say, you get it done.
Get it done.
Get it done. So you know what I'm saying? So, guys, this is a never you can't do. If you can't do it, you can always do it on your own. When there's a will, there's a way.
Remember, Beyonce also has 24 hours in a day. So
hold on, let's, you know, make shit happen. But guys, we're gonna go to a music video right quick, and we're gonna come back and introduce our guest, Mr. John Devereaux. Oh so my close. God, guys! Devereaux. I'm sorry. But yeah. We're going to go to our boy, Jimmy Hustle. He's not new to the game. You already know what this boy do. He's a guest on our show. So we're going to pay that man respect and play this music video for him.
I've only been in L.A. a couple hours and I'm already supremely fucking agitated.
Jimmy and this motherfucker, hell yeah I am. Moving work through the phone, niggas call me telegrams. I got cookies by the pound, these are no Teddy Grahams. Sitting in a teddy bear, hit my cell when it land. Been a man on demand, shit the land is my land. As a youngin' we was counting hella bands of them grands. Me and Nubs in the basement with them fucking sandwich bags. Separating ounces of stuff and cigarellos with the sand. Blowing gan way before the war in Afghanistan. Adolescent doing shit to make me the fucking man. 17 years old saying I'm the fucking man. Understand daddy wasn't there, so I took the stand. And the money wasn't there, so I had to make a plan. Make them baggies disappear by the time I hit the pad. Young lad and the hustle seemed to be my gift to gab. Cause on the slow day the work moved pretty fast. I got that Super Cali fresh shit, roll it up and test it. I got it by the pound and I know my shit the best. I got that Super Cali fresh shit, roll it up and test it. I got it by the pound and I know my shit the best. I got that Super Cali fresh shit, roll it up and test it. I got it by the pound and I know my shit the best. I got that Super Cali fresh shit. I'm like a menace, no dentist. Get in they mouth like a dentist. Nina Ross played the side, I call that bitch the apprentice. I run shit from Cleveland to Venice. Granddaddy, perp, old soul, money vintage. $40 Levi's and I'm true to my religion. Pocket full of dead presidents. And nigga, I ain't did no killing. Spent some big faces on a big face. Leave them shit face. Daddy dumb dope, put a bitch in a bitch place. Money is the motive, so I go like locomotive. Did the local thing. Nah, nigga trying to go global. Fam Royale, but I still do the solo. Go hard no matter what, only dummies say YOLO. Moved out to Cali, hang with Crips, Bloods, and Cholos. That go loco if a nigga wanna act loco. Flow deaf like so-so, money is all I know so. Try to block the hustle, you get blocked by the fofo. I got that Super Cali fresh shit, roll it up and test it. I got it by the pound and I know my shit the best. I got that Super Cali fresh shit, roll it up and test it. I got it by the pound and I know my shit the best. I got that Super Cali fresh shit, roll it up and test it. I got it by the pound and I know my shit the best. I got that Super Cali fresh shit.
All right, guys, and we're back, man. That's the boy, Jimmy Hustle, man. That's a dope video. Shout out to Jimmy. Man, call in, Jimmy. You already know I told you I got y'all. He cut
yes,
my hair.
Yes, Jimmy,
shout
you need
out
a choreographer.
You
know, let me know, because those girls in the back.
Oh.
They were cute. They were cute. They were cute, Jimmy. They were cute. Just call me if you need a choreographer.
Oh.
No, they were cute. Why are you playing?
Jimmy,
she played too much, huh?
In the valley, too, so.
I mean, well, we right next door.
Jimmy, you know what I'm saying? I ain't got nothing to do with all that.
Jimmy, they were cute. They had the same
that's
colors.
That's Anisha, you know what I'm saying? But
they were cute.
The video was dope, yeah. You know, they were, you know, but... You know, okay. But hey, Jimmy. Yeah, boy, shout out to you. But yeah, we got my boy again. We got him up here, Mr. John Devereaux. In the building. I had to make sure I get it right this time, man. So y'all talking about me, man. So let's try.
Yeah.
All of them, boy, what's going on? He's an actor.
Yes, I am. I'm an actor, singer, half a dancer. It's all good.
Ooh, oh, yes, half a dancer.
Doing major things out here, right?
Yeah. I just got off a little show called Rent.
Come on now. Come on, he need applause on that one. Shout out to Rent. Let's get that boy some applauses real quick.
Yeah.
We got applauses.
So.
Which I don't know.
amazing.
Yeah, that is. How was that?
He be doing commercials and stuff.
Yeah.
Commercials. I got like Wheel of Fortune commercial.
Come on. Now,
so he was living too. He had lines.
Look, so you got residuals.
You
know, you come
paid.
On, residuals.
You get paid.
Yeah.
When you got lines.
You know what I'm saying? Take that photo camera, your line.
He went off. He went, and he like pulled them back too.
Yeah. I ain't mad at it.
I low key stalked his Instagram.
Look, and he just stalked your Instagram. I did too, man. You know.
I wasn't going to wear makeup today, and then I saw his Instagram. I was like, oh my God.
Damn. So now, like, fuck me. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, well, you cute. Damn. We go way back. You cute.
We were shooting marbles behind the building. You heard me.
All day.
Well, yeah, John, man, where were you born and raised?
Houston, Texas, man. That's my
down
city.
South, yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm a New Orleans, Baton Rouge native, you know.
You know, Devereaux, that's...
Yeah, right, you know, from, that's Creole, right, you know. There, yeah. Right there, Louisiana, Lafayette.
Yeah, and then I went to school in Fort Worth.
Okay.
So, and then right after I graduated, I moved out here.
So how long you been out here in California?
3 years.
Okay.
That's it. He's already booked.
Yeah. Hey, man, Eddie, man, do the thing. You came out here saying, I got a mission and I want to execute it. And
you're doing
it.
It's happening.
And you're doing it. Hey, look.
It's happening.
So, did you come out here like to act, or like what made you come out here? What made you want to start acting?
The funny thing about how I got into acting is really I was forced into it by my friends back in high school. Mm-hmm. All my friends were in this show. And a guy dropped out, and they were like, we need somebody to do it. And I was bookworm at the time. I kind of still am. And I was like, no, I don't want to do it. Right. But they made me do it. And I saw it more as a chance just to hang out with my friends and whatnot.
Right.
But when I got on stage, I just felt like this is what I'm meant to do. This is something that that I want to do in my life.
Right.
So I made that my mission, man. As soon as I graduated, literally... After I graduated, I did a show in the Northwest, and as soon as that show was done, I moved right out here and started making stuff happen.
Look, man, that's the name of the game, is making stuff happen out here.
He better be. He's smart. He be on film.
I'm gonna have commercial. To ask you out on a date soon.
He knows how to act.
You know,
they talk. Where we going?
Wherever you want to go.
Me and my girlfriend. Well, I have a girlfriend, so that's two of us.
Okay. All
right.
I'm into the three things.
All right, just
and I mean that I ain't mad at it for the first time.
Look, talk about dates. All right, so I was stuck in his Instagram.
Right.
Can I show this picture?
Yeah. Yeah.
What picture?
You cleaning the house.
Oh.
I was like, he's cleaning.
I don't like to wear shirts around the house.
He don't like to wear clothes, period. Let's talk about
it's
that.
Hot.
This is how he cleans the house. This is the picture that made me put makeup on.
Look.
I was like, ooh. But yes, I'm sorry to blow up your spot like
that. Nah, that's all right.
He knows because it was a cute pic. So he was like, go ahead. It's cool.
Ain't mad at it. Well,
sorry.
That's cool, brother.
Yeah,
I think we got a clip to play of you, John. Let's see.
Oh, what y'all got?
Yeah, look.
Dum dum dum.
Hold on. Okay, we're gonna get that clip up real soon. I could have sworn up. But anywho, guys. Okay, what else I got here for you, John? Lord, I am stuck over here.
Are there any actors that inspire you?
There's Brian White, Brian J. White. He is a real inspiration to me. He's kind of who I want to be as an actor. You know, he's an actor, philanthropist. He was in the NFL and the National Lacrosse League. He's done so much and has a family. And all this by the age of...
You see it on there?
Like 37, he's 37, 38 now. Mm-hmm. And he's accomplished all that stuff. So that's what I want to do, and that's where I want to be. And even young actors like Michael B. Jordan, you know, I want to be where he's at. I just know, like, as if I have somebody that I model my career after, a goal, something I can aspire to, I'm set. You know, I just got to know where I'm going, and I'm good. My quote on my website is, the world steps aside for those who know where they're going.
Ooh, for real.
So.
I like that quote.
Yeah.
I might steal it. Like, what pushes you to get into, like, the characters? Like, what like, motivates you? Or, like, what are some things that you do to, like, get into
really
character?
Get into it? You know, some people think that acting is really just, you know, pretending to be somebody else. But one of the things that I really learned was that acting, every character you do is a piece of you. Mm-hmm. Like, there's a part of you that is a killer.
Right.
Like, you just have to find the right scenario. Right. Like, if somebody stepped to the person you love most, ooh, or hurt somebody,
true,
you know,
true,
that would turn you into a killer, and you just take it from there, and like, I'm a serial killer. That's
I thought
how
you sounded crazy real quick.
No.
I was like, there's a part of everybody. I was like, it is true, because if someone's going to try to kill you, like, I'll go ham.
What was your natural instinct beat? You know what I'm saying? Like,
I'd be
exactly.
like...
Exactly.
Right. I'm going to ask you, you know what I'm saying? I feel what you're saying, because you do have to be able to pull from somewhere, and I was going to say that. You know how you have... trained actors, who go to school and do it by the book, and then I feel like you have actors who actually went through and experienced life, who actually can just pull it from
anywhere.
Like anywhere, what I'm saying? And I think that as for me, that's how I was. I went to school, just to get the foundation and the basics of acting, but it's really just for me just going through the experience. And just really knowing your range, what I'm saying?
Exactly. Like if you know even if you haven't gone through an experience before, there's a part of you that can pull from something.
Exactly.
If you need to be enraged, you don't need to be enraged about the person that just got off for killing your mother. You can be enraged about, you can use that that time you were in traffic and somebody cut you off and you were enraged.
And
so use that. People don't need to know.
Something that really channels you to get there.
And I think that's the fun of acting, is really just diving into who these characters are. You like take a piece of you and make it the foundation, and then you just can build on that, and it's just
layer
a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing.
But so you mean to tell me, like, 3 to 4 years ago, you never even thought about acting like that, because you were just doing your thing, you were in the books, you were learning, and your badass friends came through, because everybody has that clique.
I had that clique.
And they just wanted you to like just chill with them, and you just ran with it.
Yeah, especially like when I didn't know I could sing until maybe 4 years ago.
Okay.
I just started.
Can you hit like an F sharp for us?
Right.
Like, do you have like a
I don't have
like...
perfect pitch, but I can hit some notes.
You can hit a note.
He can't hear himself.
I can hit notes. I don't have. I gotta get warmed up.
Right. What kind of music you like?
Music I like. I like all types of music. I mean, country really isn't my deal, But when it comes to, show tunes and Broadway and stuff like that. Mm. I'm really into shows like In the Heights.
Right.
New show by that same composer, writer, is Hamilton, which is a hit on Broadway right now.
Okay.
I really like these contemporary shows. I'm not too much into the classics, the whole legit thing.
Right.
Because, you got to work your voice for that type of thing. And I'm not as vocally trained as I want to be.
Right.
Because my first time singing was in college for a show that I didn't think I was going to get cast in. And then I got it, and then my director and my instructors, the head of my department, came to the show. After the show, I'm meeting everybody in the lobby, and he comes up to me and says, "John, I didn't know you could sing like that." And I said, "Neither did I."
Right.
Surprise for both of us.
Won't he do it?
Willie won't.
Right. Exactly.
Will.
Right. But guys, to our next segment, man, we got the clip up. All right, guys, we're gonna play this clip of my boy John. Let's watch these chops.
Oh, this is long. This is long.
Oh, make them hear you.
That's out.
Okay, man, I think I cut you off too fast.
Now, I mean, you can go with the end. There's one from Rent that the end of that clip.
It was a montage.
Okay. A little montage, you know.
Well, I'm going to play that.
It's just at the very end. You know, it's the title, not the title song, but it's special.
All right, guys, so y'all check this out.
In our struggle, we were not the only ones. Make them hear you. Make them hear you. Your son can be a servant or the power of the pen. Teach every child to raise his voice. And then my brother's dead.
All right, guys.
He be running that stage, though.
I'm trying,
you
know. You
saw how he walked up to him. He was like,
I'm going to tell you how to do this.
Man. Let's go.
I think we got one more clip.
One more.
The Rent one, though.
Yeah, it's at the very end. It's even after that one. A little bit after that.
The Rent was cute.
Yeah.
Let's get
one more little clip.
He came through.
I'm trying, you know. Trying to give y'all some stuff.
Wow, that's good. We got you, brother.
You know, yeah, it's about right there.
All right, here we go.
It's after this. This is me and Rick. That was
boy John on Rent. So man, y'all need to check him out definitely, man. Where you going? Is it on tour right now?
No, but I just finished it. And I'm going to rehearsals for a show at the Saban Theater. It's a Christmas show called Jingle Bell Rock.
All right,
He like finished the show and then
I go
another one.
I got
that's
you.
How I be. When you double, you get a pull like this.
Booked and blast, you
Love.
Just be hopping.
I ain't
booked
mad at y'all.
We did that.
Well, we gonna hit our Throwback Thursday segment on y'all. You know how we do, man. We pull them pictures from Throwback from that way back when. You know, and hit y'all with that. Damn, you know. So, so who we got up next, man? Who we running first? Oh, my girl. Yeah. Happy birthday. Who? Anisha.
Oh,
yeah.
Gosh. First off, I hate Josh.
I'm about to get on you.
You know what? I'm not even mad because you know what? That cake came from a really special person, one of my fans from Chicago.
Okay, shout out, fan.
That cake while I was on tour.
Well, I got to say, man, who took a bite out that bitch first before you took a picture?
Did.
Oh, you did that? You
yeah,
sure
you know
did?
I took a piece. You take a piece and then you remember to take the picture?
Right.
It was just that good.
I feel that shit. I ain't mad.
Yo, not Nazara. Nazara. Nazara is her name.
Make me a cake shit.
Yo, she was in Chicago. Long story short, I hate you. Ooh. Anyway, that was like on tour.
What year was that?
It was about I was on stage for my birthday. It was my birthday, and it was called the Snowstorm Tour. I was with T-Pain, and it was
T-Pain.
And I was on stage, and I saw my little flyer. It said, "Happy birthday, Anisha." I was like,
"Happy birthday, Anisha."
So I went up to her, and she was like, "Oh my God, we got you a cake." She like had it. I was like, "Oh my God, I didn't know it was that serious."
Right. It was.
And she had the cake and everything. She knew my favorite color was red. That's why it was red.
Right.
So
the picture, you know, I was cute though. I had the whatever earrings those were.
But man, that was dope though.
Curls were on, you know, the curls were on fleek.
Right. Come on, so shout out for the fan. You
yeah,
know,
that was really cute.
On her birthday.
That was dope
to be on your birthday, be on tour with T-Pain. Come on now. You know, shout out to T-Pain.
That was fun.
For real. All right.
T-Pain.
Who we got next? We got Mr.
Yes,
man. Oh, George! Oh, all right. What? Come on, man, because I'm hopping on your hand too.
You know what? Interesting story.
Interesting story.
Interesting story.
Smooth.
Yes, pinstripe.
No, they casket suit, Jesus.
Yes, my prom date.
So my prom date.
Yes.
Okay.
She's a beauty queen.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
That year, she was Miss Black Teen Texas. So I went to prom with 2008 Miss Black Teen Texas.
Miss Black Teen Texas.
You better go off.
No, y'all was in the country. I know y'all must have been in the country.
That was in Houston. That was like that was spring Texas. Because
that suit, man, it looked like casket suit.
That's one of those things you get like from out.
That's casket wear.
I was fresh to death.
Yeah, you know, I ain't even mad.
You buy a coffin, you get the suit.
You get the suit. Yeah, you die in it, you know.
Oh, we're not done.
We're not done. Okay, let's see. Who we got next?
She only got one.
Okay,
man, that's a Q&A. Your graduation.
This is my college graduation. Okay. Oh, that's my grandma.
Grandma, shout out, grandma.
My grandmother passed away. I'm sorry to hear that. Rest in peace, grandma.
But she looked like she was just.
She was just living. She had like a little wine cooler that day too. So she was like, ooh, like she was like, ooh. I was like, grandma, what happened? She said, the fizz. I was like, ooh, okay, you cute. Right. Ew. Anyway, I'ma mess Josh up. But my graduation day was my first show with T-Pain on tour. Wow. So I missed my graduation and went on tour to California, my first show.
Okay.
And when I went back home, I was back home for a few weeks, and my mom threw this big, huge cookout, and she made me stand outside in my cap and gown because I didn't get to wear it. Mm. And, you know, she made me walk through. She didn't tell me she had my diploma, so she, like, gave me my diploma, and I was just about to move to L.A., so my friend came. She gave me my first business card. That day was cute. I mean, I'm not mad at that day. That day was cute. I didn't know I was going to pop up again. But,
mama said, you going to take them graduation pictures. I don't care if your ass didn't walk in. Come your ass outside.
It was all about me, so it was cute. Like, the whole cookout.
I ain't mad at it. Let's see what else we got up there.
What's next? Oh, yes, first headshot.
Really, though? Ever? Ever?
You look totally different now, okay? That was a transformation right now. Okay, y'all see that boy now? He look like Hawk Loki.
Transformation Thursday.
Right?
Transformation Thursday. They put a face full of makeup on me. That was my first, agency I was with in Houston, Page Parks. I don't know. Josh, why'd you pick these pictures?
You know what I'm talking about.
I know, but you like went way back, like first Facebook pictures ever.
That's kind of how I am.
Okay, I'm gonna cut
this
everybody off. But I got the style traffic right now. Cause see, Joshua over here, man. If y'all don't see his ass right there. You know what I'm saying? He did not put my Throwback Thursday picture on there, so I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. But Lauren got one up here for me real quick, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
Because he be on it for me.
He's on deck.
He is already, you know?
All hands on deck.
And guys, we ain't even cutting into no commercial break, honestly. Because Anisha, what she don't know is she is about to choreograph a little dance for us real quick, and everybody's about to be up.
Hey.
Everybody.
So we're going to turn up.
Yeah.
Turn up.
Now, guys, don't fault me or the song she picked. You know what I'm saying? She chose to do this.
Listen.
You know what I'm saying? So y'all going to throw stones. Throw it at her ass, all right? You know what I'm saying? But I am going
to
dance.
Everybody dances to this song. They do. Love it or hate it.
Yeah, I mean, I like
gonna
it.
We're going to dance.
All right, man. Okay, shout out. That's my Throwback Thursday. I mean, I got that same shirt on right now. What the fuck?
He do.
Shout out to D Woods. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Danny DK, man. That was on
Yes, D.
What else we got up there?
Looking like Joe.
Oh my gosh, he put my no ass.
Make it rain.
That was shot up about 2008, 2009, man. Y'all, I ain't had no abs.
Chasing waterfalls.
Yeah.
Be sick to the rivers.
That's okay, though, man. I gotta put my head down.
That was older than 2008.
That was
2006.
Ooh.
2 years.
I think that was shortly after I met you.
No, don't try to start on me, you know what I'm saying? But that's okay, because look at me now.
Did you get wet, though? Like, were you cold?
Yeah, it was like a black wall, and it just had water going down.
So you went to a public situation?
Yeah, and I seen it. I was like, man, this would be a dope photo shoot.
And you did that.
I did that thing. Yeah, I mean, what y'all don't know is I do the damn thing.
You did that.
Yeah. Okay, guys, so, man, this is our last segment of the day. Before we get into our choreogram, our little dance, you know, we turn up real quick. I do want to shout my dad out, man. It's his birthday tomorrow. Rest in peace,
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Woo!
Turn up, James. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But anywho, man, shout out to my cousin Maurice too. Your birthday was like yesterday, man. Oh, my mom too. Aww. You know, all that. You know, you
everybody's safe birthday. Trip.
Hmm. Yeah, my mom out there in Colorado trying to get her skin on. So
she's sipping shots right now.
Yeah, well,
she's
husband.
Sipping.
Social media.
Oh, yeah, guys, you already know, man. Shout out to Cameo Live, follow up. And didn't I tell y'all to call in, man? 323-965-1600. Literally, y'all got like 5 minutes, man. We shutting this shit down.
All it in.
Their social media.
Oh, I got them, too. I got them. And look, guys, you know I told y'all last week, if y'all didn't follow me on Facebook or Snapchat, you know I told y'all I dyed my beard right here so y'all don't see this thing.
Oh,
look
yeah.
at this thing.
Aww.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, you know, shout out to my boy Danny. You know what I'm saying? You watching, holler back. You know what I'm saying? So let's get these shout outs. John, shout us out. Let them know where they can find your ass at and let them know where you're working on. Excuse my French. I do apologize.
Well, man. You can find me at TheJohnDevereaux on Devereaux. Instagram. It's pretty easy. Snapchat, JohnnyBNice90. Mm. And you can catch me, like I said, at the Saban Theater. December 15th, 16th, 22nd, and 23rd, doing a Christmas show.
Mm-hmm.
Christmas songs, hilarity. Just come on down.
Jingle Bell Rock.
Come on Jingle down. Bell Rock. That's yes. what it's called.
Jingle
it's a raucous
Bell,
review.
Jingle Bell.
You can get tickets at Ticketmaster.
Oh, you already know.
Oh, they fancy.
You already know, legit.
Master.
You already don't play. They ain't doing
Jingle
no crazy
shit Janet's
over there.
Where Janet be selling
right.
her tickets.
Right, you want your money.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so you already know. Y'all can't even come in there. Don't ask for no discounts.
Nope.
Don't come in on saying, you know, my
don't
leg.
Ask for no
yeah,
discount.
I got five people
we
with me.
We might be on gold.
I was about to ask for the discount, though. Can
nah.
we get...
I mean, I might have some cons for y'all.
Cameo
but,
Live, yeah.
Maybe.
Said, oh, well, right. definitely Cameo Live will definitely get a discount.
Well,
you
now
already
Cameo
know
Live
how we
can
come,
get discount.
Know
you know what?
what
I'm leaving.
You know?
All right, Nisha, let them know where they can find your ass. That girl.
What up? You can find me at Niche Nation on Instagram. Niche Nation.
My girl said Niche Nation. She got
two E's.
N-E-E-S-H. Troopers behind
Nation.
Her.
If you don't know how to spell Nation, then don't hit me up. No,
damn.
No, I'm just kidding.
All right, Raven Simone.
I don't know how to be spelling either. So
yeah,
it's all right.
I feel like me too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
go ask your cousin how to spell
it.
You know
I be stressed sometimes. I be stressed
like
a lot of times.
It's hard out there, man.
So if you don't know how to spell it, it's N-A-T.
She goes in there and spell Nation.
O-N. Niche Nation. Pretty much anything. YouTube. All of it.
All
just
of
type in Niche Nation and you'll find me.
Right. And guys, you already know where y'all can find me at. Cameo Live 2.0. You can find me on Instagram, DKP222. On Snapchat, DKP2222. Facebook, Cameo
all the
Live. All that good shit. what we got? Oh, guys, coming up next week, man. Y'all definitely want to be here. We all going to have a live audience. You know what I'm saying? I really don't do the live audience thing, but we are going to pack this little bitch out here real quick. Yeah.
Tell them why.
Tell them why, because we got the freaking boys in the building. You
oh
know
my
what
God,
saying?
I love this.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
So I'm going to be here.
Yeah, so shout
just
out.
Just invited myself.
Yeah, already. So y'all tune in, man, because we're going to be live and direct.
Boo.
Yes, my boy came in here. We're going to do the damn thing.
Are they
going
to sing a song?
Yeah, man, look. Y'all just wait the next week, man. I ain't even going to let y'all know.
I'm
going to
make them do everything.
Yes. So, man, we about to get this dance segment on. My girl about to...
5, 6, 7, 8 over in this beat.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, we're going to take it to our wireless mics real quick. Lauren, can you please pass me the wireless mic and get this song turned up? John, get over here, buddy.
Dang, I thought I was going to make it out of this.
I feel like an artist then. I'm going to turn it up.
That don't work.
Lauren,
that don't work.
All right.
John, come on. Oh, we're going to come back here. All right, going to move these chairs.
What's going on?
You going to dance.
You going to intro? All
right, here we go.
All right, guys, look. Y'all already know I can't dance at all, but I'm going to try to attempt.
Thank guys, you. I made it. This is also a part of my clothing line.
Oh, yeah? Y'all check that out.
Bow.
Konnichiwa.
Niche Nation. It is actually Japanese. It's Unseen Nation.
Get it down.
Bow.
Come on now.
We can talk about this. Just give me a jacket and we'll turn
right.
it up.
All right, guys.
So we'll always go off the right hand. So right.
Right.
Solid
time. Okay.
Right.
Solid
time. With back to the right. Let's just do everything.
Here we go.
6, 7, 8. Right hand.
Yeah.
Right hand. Back.
Come on.
Watch me.
Here we go. Hey. Yeah.
Get it.
Come on. Y'all watching? Oh. Let's go. Let's go.
Get out.
Let's go. Oh. Come on. Break your legs. Hey. Oh. Break your legs. Hey. Break your legs. Hey.
Break your legs. Hey. Break your legs. Hey. No, instead of bopping, we're gonna dab. Okay. We're gonna dab. We're gonna switch it up. Ready? Now I mean bop, 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 bop. Hey, switch.
Oh, I bop. Look, y'all keep up here. Now watch me whip. Now watch me nay nay.
Okay. Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me nay nay.
Why me do it?
I feel like my nay be y'all.
Kill it.
Watch me nay nay.
Okay. You gotta open your chest.
Okay. Watch me nay nay.
Can you do it?
Now watch me. Watch me. Watch me.
Oh.
Watch me. Watch me.
Oh.
Move around.
Okay. You know, I can get ratchet on y'all real quick.
Get him, get him. Oh,
we in this thing. Look, that's how we do it on Cameo Live 2.0. Man, y'all tune in next week. Y'all stay blessed. Stay up. We off this thing. Yeah. Tune in next week, you guys. I'm off this thing. I love y'all. And we signing out, man.
Hold up, hold up.
Just in and off like that, you know what I'm saying? You really don't want to in and off just like that.
What you saying?
Okay.
What's up, everybody? This is LP from the Only Hip Hop Show, RMC's engineer, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Cameo Live. They just had them guests in the building, you know what I'm saying? So tune in on Thursdays, you know what I'm saying, 10 to 11. And tune in to my show, the Only Hip Hop Show, Tuesday nights, 9:30 to 10:30. We got some special guests coming in next week. Peace.
Our engineer had to give a shout out.
He did.
Shout out to Laurent. Thank
shout
you.
Shout out
thank
to
you.
Laurent.
He did that. He said,
hey, wait, hold up. Most of all,
he's just trying to be on mine.
The Only Hip Hop Show is celebrating all month because, one, the 50th anniversary, 50th episode is next week.
Y'all hear that?
Following week is the 1 year anniversary. And the following week, we will be off, but my debut EP, Laurent's Progression, will be released. And on the 29th, we're going to have everybody talking in. There ain't going to be no guests. It's going to be everybody. It will be a party. There will be some performances. And I'm going to perform my debut single, Rexurrection, from my debut album, Judge Jury Execution.
I'm cutting this mic off right now. But y'all check Laurent out, man, on the Only Hip Hop Show, man. But it's Cameo Live 2.0, man. I want to thank everybody for tuning in, man. I want to thank Anisha, man. She's a wonderful co-host, man. We definitely going to have her back. She's going to be back in next week, right?
I think I am. I'm ready.
Oh, yeah. We're going to tell them to read the Freaky Boys next week. John, boy, come over here. And we got my boy John again. I do want to thank you again for
coming. I don't know. Why are we so low?
That's okay. Oh, right.
Yeah.
Well, thank y'all for having me. I'm having so much fun.
Already. Come on, call your people, bring your people next time, man.
Call them up.
Already. 323-965-1600, man. Next time, we want to hear from you. I don't know why y'all scared to call in, man. We are not going to roast y'all asses, you know?
Well, maybe.
We might, you know.
I think I might roast somebody.
You never know. But we're going to have Anisha back on the show. And we're going to have John on the show. And we got, you know, Joshua over there always, you know what I'm saying? And we all just saying, I love y'all. Good night.